system. And that happens in everything we do, from traffic to systems. the kinds of sensor and vehicle-to-vehicle capabilities that are present in Google or somebody else with you. Driverless car, and the land is probably a driverless bus system. One car, the person who had a is working with the sensor who set up the car, is able to start by their speed and create the congestion, because once one car stops, the other one stops. That's how congestion goes. But if you have a sensor that will tell you that your speed is going to be regulated, and then you can set the speed of your cars that are all working on the step managers, and then you can pick up the slogan. A GIS based store for personal information, like in the Tesla car, there are all available for us to be able to navigate, but also to figure out how much more efficient ways to get around. I was telling you that the millennials, these my generation kids, they have a different point of view. For instance, they would prefer to have a smartphone than a car. That's true. They would rather have a smartphone. You know why? Because they can, they'd rather spend the money on the data plans that are necessary to get into the car. And they want to be able to communicate with their friends. They want to do some other things. So one of the things that has been created is being a automotive has created these cars. They're called cars to go. And it's part of that system so that you have to move from point A to point B. You don't have to own a car. You would just use one of their cars. Or maybe that's not the most efficient way to go. Maybe what you need to do is ride a bicycle. A lot of cities have those bicycle plans. Or maybe by taking subways or by taking some other trains, you can get from point A to point B better. And there are apps out there that tell you to analyze for you. There's some big data object out there for you to tell you how to get from point A to point B in the best way possible. So, in the future, your logistics and maybe your movement systems aren't necessarily in a car or even in transit. Maybe walking is a better solution, as long as there's the capability to do so. And there will be technologies that will tell you how to assist you in moving forward. So smart cities are working on some very big ideas. One is to instrument the world's systems, interconnect them, and then make them useful for what you're going to need them for. In other words, intelligent. Grids that are going to be created will support those kinds of systems. And many of the vendors are already analyzing these kind of things to open cloud systems, ways for city planning operations to work. But those big wizards behind us, so public-private partnerships, are very well. Because government can't afford all these things. Institutions are, in fact, researching a lot about this, but needs to get the research done. And the private sector can benefit from this, but needs to also be part of the system issue. So, a couple of things that I want to just tell you about the project used to promote for the first 10 years is one step about high quality infrastructure, creating high speed broadband, working with organizations to create what we're talking about today, smart cities. I'm very happy to hear in the last 2 days that we're just about infrastructure. All those other things and more need to be considered as part of the smart city in the future. We have to look at education, innovation. Look at collaboration. You've heard about big governments. Planning, urban design, and architecture are very important as part of this process. Ensuring that the culture and diversity and heritage processes are retained. Body kinetic means to you have to look at how we're able to get this kind of follow up on these things. Digital inclusion is really important. I've heard a lot about that in the last 2 days. Understand this is about people, not just about infrastructure and processes. We have to look at sustainability, health, and safety. At the end of the day, you have to be able to market
tell us that you want to get the best quality of the data at the IRB of demand, plus you, or your own form of the market, and its ideas. At the end of the day, we're using the technical and public policy to be able to advocate and promote to keep this going, but also to create better consumers. So, ICF has created a very simple set of systems that says we're going to share information with the world free of charge. For 20 years, we ask the cities to give them ICF information about those cities that we can share with the rest of the world. But we want to alleviate cities that are meeting the criteria. You can't have 20 pieces of criteria, so we came up with 5. But we made it simple for cities to be able to compare themselves. Little towns as small as a couple of thousand people. Big cities, biggest challenge ever, 4,300 people. They all qualify based on this criteria. So the first thing is the red bar, all about the smart city applications, infrastructure, broadband, ability, logistics, both forms, sustainability, and so forth. But the idea of those elements that have the education that we're going to take out to make these things happen, at the end of the day, it's only useful. These are amazing tools. The transportation is a way to make something that has that high-speed broadband and other technologies. What you want is to also get the people to be educated and be able to use it. And once you have educated people and you have smart systems, now you can build it and you can create it and you can tell your friend to that because all the other things are planned. Another thing that we found out is the message about people and we're talking about all the society, disenfranchised, those people who don't have access, single mothers, and so forth. So digital inclusion is a very important part of this. And that, again, marketing and advocacy, and so forth. So infrastructure, yes, very important, but it needs the new set of logistics infrastructure elements, not as high speed, but I think that's part of it. We also have the big time. There's some good work that's been done now with FDA. But don't forget, knowledge and development and training is very important as part of this process. Or else you're never going to be able to get there and make any impact on each other. And then everybody is supposed to be part of this. And then, around the corner is the Internet of Things. That changes everything. It's a very topic, but it's very important for you to think about. The kind of research that's going on around the world. For transportation, for logistics, such as a car is very important now. I think you need with institutions like that forward. So the future of these smart and even more intelligent communities actually depends on our ability to resolve some of our challenges. And in order to do that, I think we need to think beyond the box for simply transportation. Thank you. visits to the cities in our water, water medicine, but also look forward to seeing you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. John, for the invitation and for the lovely presentation. I would now request Alexander Pilovsky, Deputy Director General, Commission Group, Sistema, Russia, to present before us intelligent smart urban mobility benefiting socio-economically. Over to you, sir.
Good evening, everyone. I'm sorry for this day, I'd like to say many appreciations for the people who collect us here, who organize this brilliant work. Thank you very much. Special thanks for Indian language of God. These people do so much positive for these initiatives. Members here in India who do not special with such strange things. Indian country with many thousands of years story. This is really old country. But here I feel real young energy. This positive effect really do the things that I begin to understand there are this more disorder. We want, we wish, we will. I think that it will be really indeed. That's what. I appreciate your efforts to be here in the other session. I will not push you towards the information. I told a story about short project, two-year project in Moscow, our capital of Russia, where we built international transport system. Part of Safe City program in Moscow was started by our mayor. And this program, part of Smart City. Today we saw many things about Smart City, but just now, nobody knows what it is. Because each city, each country is a different story with all things, but it's a peculiar, different story in my city. And I will tell you about the story in my city. Moscow Smart City Project. Some figures that was already completed. I think it's fully completed project and just now it's already support stage we put more than 2,000 TV camera recognition of the roads to control traffic. We installed about 9,000 intellectual buses. In our city, we install GPS sensors and terminals, video cameras, and Wi-Fi hotspots in each bus. We put more than 6,000 traffic detectors across the roads to control traffic situation on our roads. We put more than 1,500 road lights connected to fiber-optic lines and the very important points for two programs to provide centralized our situations. And we put about 300 intellectual displays connected to the subway system to make information for our drivers about situations and trials. And we put about 800 video systems to manage speed limit on our roads. All these combined are into the whole system of power. Our government started growing in 2012 for 4 years. The budget of this program is about $7 billion. It's based on ideas from the region of our IT department. Many other departments were involved in this work. It's the transport department, first of all, and other departments, such as the government.
Thank you. Thank you.
you very much, Alexander. I now proceed with session 4. 4 hours for waste management, reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover. For that, the moderator will be Mr. Kevin. I would request him to kindly step up and also request the speakers and Fiesta, Avi Robinovich, and Mr. Peter Woods, kindly step up on the balance, please. Thank you very much, all of you.
Do you think that you can go straight to the presentation? I'm going to be particularly interested to respond to the session that I've been recording together. Ask the speakers to stay tight to 10 minutes. I'll give you a bit of a warning if you're starting to want to show me the place to time that. That's all I'm going to have to pitch on.
So just a minute, okay. Just a minute, sir.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm very happy to be here to share some of the thoughts and ideas. The first picture you see is me working very, very hard in Utrecht. And it's a tough job of being there. And the other thing is the step that I have recently kissed the team of architecture construction. Talking about Utrecht, beautiful elephants, amazing supper deer, all of the same water that I was saying. But as we know, not everybody in India is a vegetarian. So you have to be a little bit careful. One of the things that we relatively good in the Netherlands is mapping. And with my students at School of Global Architecture, we made this map of Utrecht. In my work, I used it. This is the map of Utrecht. To encourage tourists to come to Utrecht. I think together, I hope together, we can make it much more beautiful. I used to team is working, but that's okay. India is a place on the key. So you will have lots and lots and lots of new people
in the future. Now, in the same world, we have some speakers before, Detroit lost 2 black people, 200,000 people in the last 10 years. Syrian cities. We don't have any media. I do have 10 years in South Asia, so I consider myself at least half Indian. My wife is also in the inside. In the south. If you look at space requirements, in Amsterdam, we have about 40 square meters for every person in Delhi at the start of the 10.3. So if you combine this increase of demographics with the space requirement and the ambition of the young Indian people, it means there is a big job to do. The average age in Delhi is 25.1. I tried yesterday to figure out what is the number that they said they would give me the answer, but is it somewhere between 27 and 28? Average age. So when we decided to sit in India, and we've been working in Delhi for the last 4 years, it's very important that that city is built for the people who live there. Very important to keep young people in mind. An average of 25.1 years is unthinkable. Now that we can hear it, but of course, if you can, it says younger son. So when these journalists wrote about the Delhi 2050 project, they got the conclusion we need to think about our next generation. Now I go to the lands. I go to the lands. These are my nephews, Sibu and Yano. And they're very happy. They're jumping up and down with the water. Those people are very positive with water. We like to design with water, not against water. We make houses where you don't have any traffic jams. You take your boat, you go to your house. There's no traffic jams. This is something that is very normal also for Ahmedabad in many Indian cities. After the time of the British, they make Lampoon's plans. These Lampoon's plans have two dimensions. I believe if you work on cities in India today, they should at least follow three dimensions. And the way that we work, we think in four dimensions. Because time, the fourth dimension, is very important. So what is the commitment that you really learn something and use the right tools, work together? Dutch would never tell you what to do, but we like to collaborate. If you want something, if for instance you drive in a car and you don't have to stop, you need to continue driving, you don't need traffic jam, you don't need traffic lights, and another person is in a boat. Normally, when they put together, somebody is waiting. This costs money. Why don't we use the power of design to find a solution? Not that difficult. Thank you. We couldn't read any land. The Dutch island will be obsessed with it in the land. But this square centimeter left the side for the long time. If you zoom in, you see a graphical almost abstract artistic graphics. But normally, I'm a famous painter. Maybe this subject is inspired by this landscape. So people say, no, 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 this is the great of Manhattan. Today, we're not going to talk about that, but I wanted to show you this picture. It's beautiful. Back to India. We came in India with our team in 2009, and we went to 12 different cities. We talked about long-term future of cities. We went to Delhi. We went to SPA, School of Technical Architecture, which I was teaching before. We came to Ahmedabad to set. On the left-hand side, you see the beautiful painting of Mr. Doshi, a very famous Gujarati of the kites. And on the right-hand side is Chaya. And in the middle is Mr. Bhima Patel, my president. We did it together, we took it to Goa. We came to the conclusion
that India has an organized chaos. It looks like chaos, but it's organized. Things work. You just need to look carefully. Somebody will disagree with this. I'm joking to you. Next slide. Then 2015, fundamentally rethinking the city. It's been said before, when you inhabit it, we need to rethink how do we design. Delhi has 46 million people in the national capital. We have never designed for it. We need new tools. We need to work on this today. Identity. This is what happened. You can hold this for your city. What is happening in one day? Look at the water. Look at the traffic accidents. When the stars are auspicious, we have 26,000 weddings in one day. That is a consequence for the city. Research. More research. Where do you fit in? I'm just speeding up a little bit because I'm going to from the rest. Everybody wants to be a king in your own city. So we developed two models. This is how I will wrap it up. One model we call vice chairs. A lot of people believe that if you go to Singapore, or if you go to Abu Dhabi, and you take the buildings from there and you bring it to a similar city, you have a great class city. It doesn't work like that. Please think about the space between the buildings. If the quality of the space between the buildings is great, the chances that you will have a fantastic city is more. Of course, other architects you need to be used to, but think about it. Second model, urban harvest. How can a city be more responsible? I have not heard anybody talking about the responsibility of the organization. Cities can work. If Delhi was a person, Delhi says, I'm thirsty, but I can't give me time. I am hungry, Punjab, give me some food. I want to make something, and I just started giving some building material. And once in a while, we throw the garbage. That's not a very nice question. Can cities take responsibility to be more self-sufficient, more resilient? As you can see, we built the models with issues in the area. Both of them are in Delhi, we measure 26% of the traffic doesn't want to come to Delhi. It goes from Chandigarh to Nagpur. It goes via Delhi. So when I drive in the whole webinar on Delhi, at night, all these big trucks actually don't really want to do it. So can we do urban farming? Yes, technology is there. You have it in India. The media. Some people are very critical. Architects in general don't like media. I think as long as you have a story to tell, please talk to the media. They need good text. So, I will wrap it up. What if we can reimagine now? And it is necessary to take the responsibility.